Betty Myers Middle School opened its doors in August of 2013. The Denton Independent School District's 7th Middle School was named by the Board of Trustees after Dr. Betty Myers, a longtime advocate for education in the Denton community. Dr. Myers was born in Heavener, Oklahoma in 1926 to Jay and Gladys Myers, who instilled the importance of education and civil service in her from the get-go.
I started teaching when I was 6 years old, and come home from first grade, and my next-door neighbor, 5 years old, my little table I had out and a little blackboard, and I taught her everything I learned that day. She was a nuisance the next year in first grade, however. And then, as I say, I got started being paid for my teaching when I was 20 years old, and had just fallen in love with it, of sharing and trying to help people learn what they need to know to enjoy doing what they want to do in life.
Dr. Myers enrolled at Texas Women's University, where she received her bachelor and master's degrees. She would go on to earn her PhD from the University of Michigan before returning to TWU, this time as a faculty member in 1961. It was upon her return to Denton that Dr. Myers began to establish a legacy of helping others and improving educational measures that continues today. She worked as a volunteer in the community and served on various nonprofit boards, including a stint as Denton ISD school board president.
Well, I think that's the fault, if you will, of my mom and dad, who were servants, in the sense of instilled in my brother our responsibility to give back to a community who's helped us become who we are. I love being on the school board. I love being a spokesperson for DISD because I've always believed in it.
The connection she has made with the students and staff at the school that bears her name is something special. It's not often that the namesake of a school is around to share in those unique first moments a new campus gets to enjoy. Yet Dr. Myers makes sure those moments are distinctive by not just being there, but by becoming a part of them.
Well, when she steps foot on our campus, it's like she's a celebrity. The kids get very quiet, they get very starstruck, and they all want to interact with Dr. Myers. One thing that I noticed about her is when she does interact with the students, she stops. She takes their hands, she looks them in their eyes, and she has a very engaging conversation with each student that she comes into contact with. So the students know who she is, they respect her presence, and they all want to shake her hand or be able to meet or take a picture with Dr. Myers.
It is second nature to her to make a binding connection with those she comes in contact with, which may explain why, despite never marrying or having children of her own, she is a huge part of so many families and beloved by many more.
Listen, if you can get a hug at my age from a sixth grader boy and run up and get a hug from her, you know, who's going to complain at that? No, I really love being with the children and the young people that can't call eighth graders children anymore, you know. But they have welcomed me with open arms, and I just get chill bumps when I go over there because I'm welcomed by the children as well as the staff, and I love it.
Yes, Betty Myers Middle School has some of the best educators in the state, unsurpassed technological advantages, and some of the finest facilities around. But for the students and staff at the school, the best thing Myers Middle School has going for it is Dr. Myers herself.
She has been a very welcome person in our building, and we hope to have that for many years to come.
She's known for telling students to be safe today, for she expects them to change the world tomorrow. And as long as her name adorns the school, you can expect the message inside will be the same.
No more fitting tribute than Dr. Myers being named for this school. The legacy she has with education, the passion that she has for teaching students, she exemplifies the culture that we're trying to establish here at Betty Myers. No more fitting person could have been named the namesake for this campus.